I'm a deductive deducer. Well, I just watched the news, and now I have to listen to comedy to get over it. Hi. Well, lucky I'm not too serious about the news, because if I did, because I'm listening to comedy now on my computer and stuff, if I was too serious about the news, I'd laugh so much harder. So it's just a bit funny. It's pretty funny, but cheers you up after watching the news and stuff. Hi, I'll tell you again, because I already told it last album. Well, on the last album it said, hi, everybody should Google in Pick Boogies and see if it comes up. Paula Reilly, you know, claim to fame stuff for the Pick Boogies words. And so that's what I'm doing now. So funny. It's like, you know, I put this auto suggestion in your head, Google in Pick Boogies and see if it comes up Paula Reilly, yay. And everyone giggles in Pick Boogies and see if it comes up Paula Reilly. Okay, hang on, I'll do it now already. Here we go, bringing up Google. What do I call it Google for? Well, I call it Google because that's, what I call it. Not just Google, the infamous Google, I call it Boogle. Oh, I've said Pick Google. Hang on, let me pause it. Okay, I've Googled in Pick Boogies, and it's come up Urban Dictionary Boogies Pick 1, Boogies Pick 4, Boogies Pick 2, Booger Factor, did you pick your nose and eat your boogies then on Yahoo? Oh my god, how many is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7! 7 on Google rankings for Pick Boogies! Oh my god! Oh, I've hit fame for Google! Out of 1,210,000 results, I come up number 7. Everybody try that Pick Boogies in Google and see if Paula Reilly comes up 7 or better. Okay, I brought the page up. It's on Spotify, where you can listen for free, log in and listen for free. So, if I log in, right, and listen to my own comedy, I will be creating income for myself, albeit like 0.00001 of a cent per listen. And, hey, I want to be an entrepreneur. I need every bit I can get. And that's funny. Everybody know my first ever full album sales was King Kong Pop-Up's Nerdy Afterthoughts. What a good thing, hey, my first ever album sale. I've sold like downloads and stuff, single downloads, but this was my first ever big album sale. Thank you. You know, last night I tried to stab so much, and I was watching a doctor's lecture on the enteric system, the digestive tract, and I made it, wait, it was like an hour and a half long, and I made it like doctor's big words about halfway through it, and then I was like lying down and I kind of fell asleep. But I remember in my dream I was still listening to it, thinking I'll be able to wake up soon because I'm still focusing, but then I fell asleep totally. But that probably went on for like 15 minutes, I reckon, just listening. So I missed out on all the doctor's big words, because like I try and keep up with all the doctor's big words and stuff because I'm getting used to them. But you know, not while I'm asleep, Oh yeah, another thing I'm doing is I'm listening to comedy but on one computer, and at the same time I'm looking through YouTube on another, because I have to learn about publicity and marketing online and stuff, the business side of it. So what I'm actually doing is pause the comedy for a bit while I'm talking, obviously, but I'm listening to comedy, and the comedy I've already heard it heaps of before, and I can't actually watch the YouTube videos because the comedy's on. It's like, Oh, which one? Oh, this one looks good. Nah, comedy's still on. Oh, this one? Oh, no, the comedy's still on. And it's like, my comedy is taking precedence over the business side of the issue. That's a bit funny, hey? Hey, like, you know, with that theory about listening to it instead of doing business work, you know, lucky then, if you listen to 100 comedy albums, you know, the comedy pain kicks in at about third or fourth album. It's like, nah, too much, can't listen to it anymore, hey? So then you can get your business stuff done by then because you're all laughed out and stuff at the comedy. Hey, I've got a funny. I had the flu, like, nearly for a whole month just a little while ago, and I had this whole bag of St. John's wort powder in the cupboard. So, of course, St. John's wort's like a powerful antiviral herb, and it's also boosts your mood levels. I was having that so it would get rid of the flu virus, because it's antiviral. So at the same time of having the flu, I was also giving up cigarettes. But I made up so many comedy albums, hey, even though I was giving up cigarettes. So now I'm on eBay and I'm going to get more St. John's wort herb to see if I get more funnies. Because last time I gave up cigarettes, it wasn't even funny. So this time when I give up cigarettes, God bless it, I don't be a chain smoker forever. And I do give up every second week. I'll see if it's funny with this St. John's wort herb. I also call it St. John's stuff, because then you don't have to call it the wort bit. St. John's stuff, hey. It's like, even if I'm giving up cigarettes and it gets really intense, then I have St. John's wort and I'm happy. It's gonna be happy and dance, funnies, more funnies. So yeah, that's my motivation for this little shopping spree online here. Excuse me, Sultana Brains. True story. Cognitive connectica, synaptic cognition, active cognitive synaptic connectica. Ah, oh, mega idea. I've been making up samples. Like, normally samples are just beats and a few effects noises and stuff, but I've been doing vocal samples, like, and also samples like this, Mr. Biscuit, and like really good samples like that. So I could, like, you know what normal people do, DJs and music producers and people like that, they make up a whole beats, you know, 3 gig, 4 gigs of beats, and they sell it on the internet as a download pack for Ableton and stuff, like music production software. And like, you buy sample packs, so they sell their sample packs and stuff. So I could like make up 3 or 4 gig of Paula Reilly vocal samples, like Brother Supreme, ding 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 ding, you know, excellent samples like that, and sell it as 4 gig packs for Ableton on the internet. That'd be like excellent. Then like every DJ out there could be going, you know, in their music, in their nightclub music and stuff, and they're mixing up their beats and stuff. Ah, have I had a good idea or what? Hey, well, I'm doing an entrepreneur kick sometimes, and I'm like learning everything entrepreneur I can possibly learn. And I've got like 14 box sets of comedy lined up. There's about like 10 plus albums each in each box set, and I want to sell them on the internet as box sets of excellent comedy. And I'm just looking at these boogies and pop-offs ones, and there's like 12 in it of boogies and pop-offs jokes. And, Well, so far, you know, I'm still editing it, so anyway. I'm just thinking, if someone listens to a whole album of Boogies and Pop-Offs and goes, ah, ha, 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 laughs the way through it, and then another one, ah, ha, ha, laughs the way through it, do you think, like, the number 3 to number 12 will be just as funny? Or do you think by the end of it, once they get to the 12th album, like, you know, half-hour sets each, that's like 6 hours of Boogies and Pop-Offs jokes, do you think they'll still be laughing or they'll be just going, shut up? I think they'll be so grossed out by the just sheer quantity alone of the Boogies and Pop-Offs. They'll just be going, enough, enough. And like the last one is Onion Stinkers, and that's like so gross. Hey, oh God, it's funny, but so I'm just rethinking this box set. I guess it's one of my big ideas, and I want to do it, so I should give it a go, no matter how bad it's gonna turn anyone's nose up. Hey, whatever, but whatever. I think it's funny. Hey, let me do a big burp. Do you wanna hear me do a big burp? Oh, it wasn't a big one. I thought it would be a big one, but it wasn't. Sorry. Must have been the suspense of the motivation of the thing. Like, put the burp off a bit so it just comes out as a burp. Whatever, hey. Whatever, people. Whatever. I thought it was funny at the top, mate. Whatever. Whatever. Got a thought, right? Well, you know how there's like pop-offs and boogie picking jokes and, you know, just goes on and 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 stuff like that. Does anybody ever pick pimples? You know, I think I'm greatly blessed in this life, right? You know, I've got everything I could possibly want. I got a lovely life happening. And, the only thing it is, you know, you're meant to grow out of your pimples after you're not a teenager anymore. But I'm 38 and I still get pimples. Hey! Does anybody ever pop pimples? I'm not telling if I do or not because, you know, it might be a bit taboo. But, like, if you pick boogies and do pop-offs and keep picking boogies and stuff and get the funnies and stuff and... Why, hell, you know, teenagers probably even do pop-offs on their voice recorder, or, you know, farts, love. But, you know, it's like, does anybody pop pimples as well? Do they think it's funny? I don't know if it's funny or not. Hey, it's one of those things, hey? I don't know. Like, is it actually better that it's not a pimple anymore? I don't know. Does anybody else know? Just thought I'd put the question out there. Must have been on the boogie topic. Hey, pop-offs. Pop-offs made me think it. That's what. Thank you.
Okay. Settle down out the back down there. I've just come up with my new album title. It's going to be called Pevious, Begreivious. And I was just going on and on and stuff, going, oh, it's gonna be a good one. I can feel it in my bones. It's got picking pimples and everything in it. It's like Pevious, Begreivious. I can, funny at the time, don't worry about it, eh?
Hello. Just picked up my voice recorder. I had to say something, guy.
Oh, it kind of makes sense, hey? What kind of makes sense? Oh, just my poetry. The paragraphs are like 5-6 lines long for a sentence, and it's like, it kind of made sense at the time, and now it's like, you know, it's a bit funny, hey? Yeah, it makes sense, hey, it's good poetry, good stuff, hey, I like poetry, it's good, no, it's good stuff, no, it's good, that's for sure. Get used to the big words, people, big words.
Uh,
I had a funny, but I said it already and it wasn't recording, so like, I don't care. Okay, I'll tell you. Well, it's 3 a.m. in the morning, and like nighttime, morning, 3 a.m., very early. Everyone else in their right brain mindset is asleep, and my shirt's inside out. And I just went for a run around the block with my shirt inside out, and that's like spiffy duffida, bifty buffida. You know, so gotta get your like brain working properly at this time in the morning. You can't go running around the block like everybody else is asleep, so they didn't see anyway. But you know, your shirt's inside out running around the block at this time. Okay, whatever. And also, what actually happened was before that I was watching university biological medical lectures because it's my little hobby, what I do. And I had a really funny to say on my voice recorder, but I didn't like want to pause it because it might upset the flow of the energy of the, you know, escape of the university lecture. You know, don't want to interrupt something, so you're meant to get dressed up for doctors and stuff because they're, you know, leading role models. So I missed out on the funny, and I don't know if I got my mindset right. You know, I missed a funny, hey, I have to get the funnies, hey, I should be able to like pause the doctor's lecture and go, here's a funny for ya. Here's a funny for ya, people. Oh, spiffy duffida bifta buffida for that too, hey. God, and my shirt's on inside out, and it's night time. God, what else? Quick, I've got a funny. Well, you know, right, how there's like 8 or 9 or 10 or something albums of dun, 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 King Kong pop-offs jokes, and that's the joke, King Kong pop-offs. And that's so funny, hey, because King Kong did a pop-off and it's like, massive! That's King Kong pop-offs. But, you know, because it's, you know, well, to me, it's like, it's common language, hey, King Kong pop-offs. It might be new to everyone out there, but, you know, King Kong's like the legend of my jokes, hey, King Kong pop-offs. So that's like nearly an iconic term in my household, King Kong pop-off jokes. So I just come up with a new one, hey, like snap into baby character for this, hey, King Kong plop-offs. That's what you can say if you're a baby and you're doing a plop-off in your nappy. King Kong plop-offs, baby. Very good, baby. Thank you. Okay, I've been doing like a bit of intellectual stuff tonight, just a little bit, but... And, yeah, so my brain's up there, and I guess all my, like, brain sugar's going, all my blood sugar's going to my brain, going, be intellectual, brain, be intellectual, and, you know, the processes that be in the body are just sending all the energy to my brain. But then I had some raisin toast with double extra honey, double extra jam, and lots of cinnamon, and, now all the blood sugar's going, brain, there's funnies, oi, yeah, funny, oi, so, you know, if you're down in the dumps, all you gotta do now is, be really intellectual for a bit, and, you know, do some university lectures or something, sit through at least an hour of it, you know, you can do that, right? Maybe some motor coordination, multitasking, doing something else while you're doing the university lecture. Just get your brain sugar, your blood sugar going to your brain, you know, focus on that kind of attention for your brain, mental effort. And then have some cinnamon raisin toast with double extra sugar and double extra jam, double extra honey. It's like amazing, hey, everything's funny now. Everything except waking your neighbours up at 3:18 in the morning. Sorry, neighbours. Whoops. Good one. Does anyone think that the joke where if you think you're gonna do enough pop-offs because you've got a fat tummy, so your fat tummy will go away? If you do enough pop-offs, so your fat tummy goes down? Does everyone think that's a funny joke, eh? Just checking, because I think it's so funny, hey! I wish it was true, but hey! It's like over Christmas, everyone puts on a couple of extra kilos accidentally, albeit, but accidentally. And then, like, you know, a couple of months after Christmas, it's still on the way down. Also, your excuses from Christmas or something. But, you know, if you gotta do pop-offs, why won't the pop-offs make your tummy go down high? That's a good idea. Hey, maybe we should bargain for that or something. Start up a new campaign or something, hey? Maybe. Okay, maybe not really. It's just a funny joke, that's all. Don't worry. Okay, this one's pretty bad, hey? Well, I've been bushwalking. I went yesterday up the mountain and I, like, got really tired and stuff and had like 3 or 4 or 5 hours sleep last night, and I went bushwalking again today up the mountain, and I got back like half an hour ago, and I plopped on my chair and I'm like, I'm not getting up, I'm not gonna move, I, you know, tired as, because I did it 2 days in a row because I thought it was really fun. And my cat was inside, and I have to get a cat door so he can get out by himself when I'm not home, and because I'm usually home every day anyway, and so he did a pooper on the bath mat. It's like just like a cloth bath mat, so that's all right because I'll clean it up. But I'm sitting here and I'm like, you know, I've got 100 billion things I have to do. I need at least half an hour's extra rest. And I'm sitting here going, talking to myself about my agenda and stuff, and going, oh, that cat poop is dwelling on my conscience a bit, aye. Of all things you want dwelling on your conscience, it's cat poop or in the bathroom. Oh, stinky. I'm so tired, if I tried to clean it up now, I'll gag. I have to wait at least 10 minutes, because I had my herb juice and, and I'll clean it up. I mean, of course I'll clean it up. Oh, what am I even thinking? Cat pooper on my conscience. What next, eh? Boo. Boo, boo, boo. Yeah, I thought I heard Bigfoot today. I didn't actually see the beast, but I thought I heard him because it was like footsteps. It could have been a pig or something just checking me out, but those footsteps, like crackle, crackle, twig snap, stick snap, crackle, crackle, leaves, and then stop. Footstep, footstep, and I'm like, hey, it's Bigfoot. It's either Bigfoot or the Predator. It's like, I just wish movies were real, eh? Imagine if the Predator was following you through the bush when you're bushwalking. Oh, what a sight to die by. Oh, God bless everything again. Hey, I must be tired, that's for sure. Instantaneous pickup, one salty plum, salt replacement for my near sunstroke dehydrated mountain tired everything. So now my conscience will be clear. I am doing my chores. That was just such a close call of the stinkies. I nearly vomited all over the cat pooper on the way down the toilet. Close call of the stinkies, just exactly what you need to come home and relax to, eh? At least my conscience is clear, thank God. Boo, 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 boo. Well, I'm racking my brains for comedy, and I came up with the words pea brain tea. I should have some pea brain tea, and that might rack my brains for comedy better. How do you make pea brain tea? Well, just make a tea out of some peas or something, and it's called pea brain tea. So it might make it funny. This might work. I'm racking my brains for comedy. God bless everything. Brain tea, be brain free. Pea brain tea, be brain free. You can either think this is your brain is free or you have no brain. So whichever way you drink pea brain tea, if you drink it like a snob, you will probably be no brain. But if you drink pea brain tea like a goody putty, you will be brain free. Pea brain free, be brain free. Pea brain tea, be brain free. Pea brain tea, be brain free. It's like the chant to the never beyond. Pea brain tea, pea brain free. Pea brain tea, pea brain free. It's goody, goody for all goody putties, that is. Got a funny. What happens if somebody that doesn't really talk nicely to you says stuff and then says stuff and you know, a bit annoying and stuff and they're not very nice to you and stuff, and then they ask you a question or something? I've got a good comeback for it. I get out of the situation politely to say, oh, boogie why, dude. You know, this can be your newest comeback, you know, if you have to, like, still look good in the face of all abysmal, abrupt, obtuse, ill-regulated, uncivilized manners by somebody, and you have to talk to them, you can just say, oh, boogie why, dude, you know, the boogie's blessings be will bless it, and you'll get the proper answer behind all their bullshit that they're faking in your face. This is probably possible. This is a new good comeback, hey? Oh, boogie why, dude, boogie why then, I? Filling my life with an exuberance of boogie jokes, hey? It's like the flora and fauna all over the world blossoming at once with the grand high funnies of the exuberant occasion called life. It's like boogie jokes, hey? Boogie jokes! That's excellently funny! Thank you! Chili poppers across the universe, Billy Mumba. Messed it up. Take two. Chili poppers across the universe, but my dum dum bum bum, cause I'm dum 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 dum. Chili poppers across the universe. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Stop it there, baby. Stop it, baby. Don't go there, baby. Baby, stop. Stop, baby. Chili poppers across the universe. Blah, 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 Captain Kirk. Why, says the baby, you know, that's what babies always go. They go, but why? But why can't I say chili poppers? Every time I drink chili milk, I get chili poppers, and my bum gum goes, to sing up to the stars and burning beyond. Chili poppers across the universe, but my dum dum bum bum, cause I'm dum 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 dum. Chili poppers across the universe. Just can't tell the baby anything. They gotta sing everything, aye. Whatever, says the world, whatever. After singing, says the baby, you know, the baby goes, I have to, but, you know, cool. But why, baby? But why not, hi? Where's the word gazing come from if you don't ever have a chili popper, hi? Yeah, we like this gazing word. Every time you do a chili popper, it like burns your bum bum so much, it's like the stars have set it on fire, you know? Set your kundalini of your bum bum on fire, and it goes like gazing all the way up to your head, and you get pins and needles and chili pepper gazing all over you, so much so makes you so happy that you can sing this song after you have chili peppers. Chili poppers across the universe, blah 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 blah, Captain Kirk. Thank you. But why, baby? You have to stop there. Your no credentials on what's rude. But chili poppers is rude. It's good stuff, but hi. Thank you.
If I view my credentials on what's not road and say the not road funnies, not the road funnies, what's road about having Kundalini from my bum bum to the stars, aye? Every time I do a chili papa? Now that's funny, that's not rude. Might be rudely funny, but it's funny as I jolly papa, it's across the universe. Blah 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 blah, Captain Cook. Thank you. Pick me. What's going on? What's going on? Oh, it's just my national boogies anthem, hey! Pick me. Thank you! Oh. I think because I'm just listening to my Bobby Big Boogie album on Facebook that I might have accidentally started a new fan craze. And does everybody want to know what the new fan craze is? It's called In Light of the Silver Astral Aura of the Boogie Fan Craze. And it's like all the, like, you know, people out there that forgot how to eat boogies, they start eating boogies just to see if it leaves a beautiful silver snail trail astral aura down their throats. And yeah, it's called the new fan craze. So, I think I've started a new fan craze. If you don't believe me, just listen to the Bobby Big Boogie album. It's funny. Oh, just because I'm a big baby, I'm still growing. And doesn't mean I'm a dum-dum, because, you know, I'm growing so much, I'm still getting used to the thought of having pop-offs. Like, you know, pop-offs. You know, King Kong did it. You know, stinky monsters under the under the cupboard syndrome, you know. Oh no, I didn't do a stinky. And then the pop-offs just keep coming every day. And it's like, I've grown so much in my big bubbyhood that I'm getting used to the thought of doing pop-offs sometimes. This is Big Hey. Give me attention. I'm a goodie. Goodie putty.